It's our last day of this month in February talking about behind the scenes. And today, in case you guys are wondering, I am Robin Hood dressed up, okay? A lot of people call me Peter Pan, and I guess I could if I did this number. And if I had a little dagger right here, but I'm not, I'm Robin Hood. You guys got to dress up today. Y'all look fantastic, by the way. So one more time, because it kind of was jumbled last time, count of three, you guys tell me who you dressed up today. On the count of three, one, two, three. I got it that time. All right, so we're gonna get started with today. Obviously, we're on this series called Behind the Scenes. What's that one word starts with an L? It's our life app. Someone say it like you really mean it though. Say it like you really mean it, like from your stomach. Now say it really high, like up in your head. Good job. One more time, but this time say it like an old man. Ready? All right, this time say it like a dog. Ready? This time say it like a cat. You guys are doing really good. All right, one more time. Normal voice, normal life app word is? And love is choosing to treat others the way you want to be. If there was one more brownie on the table, and you really wanted it, but your older brother or sister was gonna grab it, would you want them to show love and to treat you the way they want to be treated and give you the brownie instead? But what if the shoes were reversed? What if you were the one who was about to grab the brownie and you knew your brother or sister really wanted it? Now you gotta really put love in action. Are you going to either share it or give it to them? Or are you gonna be stingy and keep it all for yourself? Don't be stingy. Someone say love one more time. One, two, three. It's choosing to treat others the way you want to be treated. Now, I got a Bible story that I want to tell you guys today. It's wrapping up our series called Behind the Scenes. As you can tell, I got my camera right here, ready to roll. I'm going to need a cameraman to operate this. But hang on. Just a second. I actually also have behind here, I've got a box of props. Because in every movie, we're actually going to do a movie today. In every movie, there's a guy who does lights, which, by the way, Mr. Noah's back there, or he was back there. Everyone say, thank you, Mr. Noah.
Thank you, Mr. Noah.
He does a great job running our lights. Miss Haley's back there. She's running our slides. Say, thank you, Miss Haley.
Thank you.
There's a lot of people who work really hard, tirelessly, behind the scenes to make sure that a movie works just great. So today, we're going to tell a Bible story with these props in order to make today work. But before I do that, I want to bring you guys up to speed on what we're talking about. First of all, let's throw our memory verse on the screen, Ms. Haley, because this whole month we've been talking about love. We know that it's treating others the way you want to be treated, but, someone say but. But this is how Jesus described it as love. He said, here is what love is in 1 John 4:10. It's not that we loved God. No. It's that he loved us and sent his son to give his life to pay for our
sin.
So no greater love, on week number one we talked about this, Jesus said no greater love than for someone to lay their life down for a friend. Now obviously Jesus was talking about himself because he literally just said he came to pay for everyone's sins by dying on the cross for them. But Jesus isn't demanding that every day we die for somebody, because how do you die every day? That's kind of hard, right? Even though it's commendable for people who do give their lives up for us, like people who serve in our armed forces, what Jesus was saying was that we need to be willing to lay our lives down for people in order for them to succeed in life, treating others the way you want to be treated, kind of like the brownie. If you were the only one about to grab it, but you knew someone else wanted it, how would you lay your life down for that person? By giving it to them instead of you, because it's putting your desires behind the scenes and letting someone else's desires be on the stage and in the spotlight. Here's another thing, an old-time movie, I don't know if you guys have ever seen any of these before, or a musical, but normally, after it rains, I want you to picture this on the stage set, okay, like this, like a movie producer, okay? It's raining, it just got done raining, so everyone who was on the streets of the city went inside, and now it stopped raining. So people are coming out of the bakery, people are coming out of their offices, they're doing all their things, but there's puddles everywhere. Well, out of this coffee house steps this nice-looking guy and his date, this beautiful blonde girl. Well, they're walking outside, and all of a sudden, they step right in front of a puddle, and she's got a white dress on and white heels on, and she knows if she steps in that puddle, what's going to happen to her white dress and white shoes? It's going to get wet, it's going to get dirty, right? And so what does the nice gentleman do? He takes off his coat, He lays it over the puddle, and what happens next? So she can walk over it and not get her dress or her shoes dirty. See, I like to picture that image as you and me not being the girl, not being the guy, not being the guy who stepped out of the coffee shop with the people, but instead, we are the
jacket.
We're the jacket, we're the coat. We need to be willing to lay ourselves down so that someone else can step over and get ahead. That is putting someone else's needs and desires before ourselves. That is true love, and that's what Jesus was talking about. So let me bring you guys up to speed on what's about to happen. I love the Bible, and I've got a few verses I'm gonna read to you guys from it to set up today's story, and then I'm gonna have Miss Holly help me get you guys set up in these costumes. This story actually comes from the book of Luke, chapter 10, in verse 26, okay? And I'm gonna build this up for you. Jesus is talking to all these people, and everyone is loving listening to Jesus. Well, there's this one dude. He's a rich young ruler, and he knows what the Bible says, and he wants to obey it, but he's also trying to figure out how he can wiggle his way around it and obey only parts of the Bible. There are actually people still like that today. People believe in Jesus, they believe in God, they believe in the Bible, but there's a few things they kind of want to do, and there's some things they kind of don't want to do. And so, as Jesus is talking to this crowd, this rich young ruler comes up, and he knows what the Bible says, he knows what the law of God says, of Moses. Y'all remember the Ten Commandments, right? And so he comes up to Jesus, and he says this, and it's in Luke chapter 10, verse 26, this is what he says. He says this, he says, "Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?" And this is what Jesus replied right here. He says, "What is written in the
law?"
Okay, so Jesus answered his question by asking another
question.
Jesus does that. He wants us to think about it. So he comes up to Jesus and he says, "Hey Jesus, how can I inherit eternal life? In other words, how can I live forever and ever and ever? Even when I die, how can I live in heaven forever and ever?" And Jesus asked him a question and said, "What is written in the law?" Do you guys want to know what he said?
What?
Because remember, he knows what the Bible says, right? So this is what his answer was. It's in the next verse in 27. He answered, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul. Love him with all your strength and with all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. Do you think he got it right?
Yes.
Do you think he answered Jesus right?
Yes.
Raise your hand if you think he answered Jesus right. Great, put your hands down. Raise your other hand if you think he answered Jesus wrongly.
Partly.
He answered Jesus right. So here's the thing. In verse 28, Jesus even said, "You have answered correctly. Congratulations, you have won absolutely nothing." Here's the thing. Jesus replied, and I love this. He said, "Do that and you will live." Do that and you will live. Do what?
Do what?
Do what? She got it. Let's reverse the story a little bit. This rich young ruler who knows the Bible comes to Jesus and says, "Jesus, how can I live forever?" And Jesus says, "What's written in the law?" And he says, "Well, love the Lord your God with all your heart, your mind, your soul, your strength, and love your neighbor as yourself." And Jesus said, "Yeah, that's right. Do that." Do what?
Love.
Love. Love God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, with all your strength, and love your
neighbor
as yourself. And Jesus said, "Yeah, you're right. Do that." Do what? All right, let's do it again. What's written in the law? Oh, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. You're right. Do that.
What?
What was Jesus telling him to do? To love others. But remember, this guy wanted to wiggle his way around a little bit because he was like, okay, love your neighbor as yourself. So Jesus, who's my neighbor? Like, is it the person who lives on my right or the person who lives on my left? Or is it the person who lives right across the street from me? Or is it the guy who lives down the street from me? Like, he's really saying, "Jesus, you tell me, who is my neighbor?" And you know what Jesus said? I think you guys know the answer, but Jesus actually answered his question, not with another question this time, but with a story, and that is where I need some help today. So, Miss Holly, if you don't mind, I'm gonna need your help putting on some costumes today. They're kind of easy costumes. Our first costume in our store today is a robber. So this is gonna go over their face like a bandana. So she's gonna pick a robber. Mr. Brian, can you come up here really quick? Because our next one is a worship leader, believe it or not. So I need someone who's good at playing the guitar. Miss Melody, can you come up here really quick? I'm glad you're here. The next person is actually the main character in today's story. It's a Jew, which is someone who believed in Jesus, one of God's people. I need someone who you think would be a great Jew. It's not a trick question. Alright. Okay. Alright, Mr. Brian, I need someone who's going to play the part of a pastor. Someone who's going to play the pastor. Okay. Miss Holly, I need somebody who's going to play the role of a Samaritan person. Good job, looking good. All right, Miss Melody, my last role to play is someone who's gonna be a donkey. She's gonna find our donkey character. Doing great. I'm gonna move this off stage because we are about to play the parts of this. Now, if you got chosen to be the robber, the Samaritan, the worship leader, I'm sorry, the Jew, the Samaritan, the preacher, and now we've got our donkey, I'm gonna need everybody to go that way on that wall right there who's playing the parts today. Perfect. Now, the thing about this movie is, remember, we're recording today's service, and so what that means is that I'm going to describe what your character's doing, and you have to do it. You guys are right. So if I said the robber ran across the field as fast as they could, what would the robber do?
Run!
So I gotta make sure they remember. So the robber, you're the robber. If I said the robber ran across the field as fast as they could, what would you do?
Perfect.
Okay, and if I said the robber ran back, because that's where they start, what would you do?
There you go.
You guys get up for our robber. Good job, okay. All right, if I said our Jew skipped across the floor, what would she do? So you gotta skip across the floor. Perfect, you're doing great. Okay, you can go back. You guys give the Jew a round of applause. This is our auditions, okay? Now, if I said that the worship leader who has a guitar played the guitar really, really good and walked into the middle of the room and just really let it rip, what would she do? She would come out. You guys give a round of applause, though, because it's kind of hard to do this sometimes. There she goes. Perfect. There you go. She's like, all right, I'm done. And it's a pink guitar, so it works great for her. All right, if I said the preacher came into the middle of the room and opened his Bible and said amen, what would he do? That would be Bryson. You got to come right over here in the middle. You got to open your Bible and say amen.
Over here.
You got this. He's like, I'm good right there. You guys give it up for our pastor because it's kind of hard. All right, and if I said that the Samaritan, who's this guy right here in our Dallas Cowboys shirt, if I said he jumped three times, what would he do?
One,
two, three. Perfect. All right, and if I said our donkey made the sound of a donkey, what would our donkey do? Hee-haw. You guys got to help him out a little bit. There you go. Okay. All right, so here we go. Let's see. All right, if you don't want to do it, you can find someone else to take your spot. You want to find someone else to take your spot? Because y'all are going to be acting, doing this, and y'all are going to be great. He's like, I don't want to be a donkey. All right, Chris, if I said the donkey made a donkey noise, what would you say? There you go. You guys give it up for Chris. Great donkey. All right, so here's how we get into today's story. I'll be your director. Perfect. Right here. And this is probably how this goes, but I need, Mr. Brian, I know you're going to be doing something else for me in just a minute, so I think I might have Jace to be my cameraman. Y'all give it up for Jace. There you go. All right, Jace, just so you know, it is a prop, so you don't have to do anything. You just stand there. You look great. You guys get it for Jace one more time. Yeah, it's really easy. Really easy. All you do is just stand there. Like you normally do. Perfect. All right. Are you guys ready for today's Bible story?
Yeah.
Now remember, y'all have to act this out, okay? Don't be embarrassed because y'all are starting our first KidNation movie starting right now. Take one.
Action.
I'm going to do your voices for you guys so y'all don't even have to worry about it. But you got to do what I say. Are you guys ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay, the camera's rolling. Okay. A woman was taking a trip from Jerusalem to Jericho, and we'll call her Chippy. She was a Jew. Chippy was very chippy, and she skipped across the floor. Skip, 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 skip. And she stopped because she observed all the beautiful landscape that was in front of her. And just as she was viewing a band of robbers jumped out from behind a rock and went, "Roar!" You know what the robber did? The robber went over to Chippy. Went over to Chippy. There we go. Action. Doing great. She didn't give her a hug. No. You know what she did?
Beat her up.
She pushed her on the floor. And she fell down. And Chippy said,
"Oh, my leg! Oh, my leg!"
And Chippy started to cry because the robber started beating her up. But hold on. Stop. This is where, in our movie, we have our stunt double. So, Chippy, you can go to that side really quick. Enter stunt double. Wait.
Who are these kids?
And action. And she grabbed Chippy and started beating him up. She would pick her up, and she would punch her, and she would hit him on the floor, and she would throw him on the ground, and it was horrible, and it was the worst thing ever, and it was just horrible, and while you gotta beat her, you gotta do better than that. Y'all gotta cheer her on. She's doing a great job. Alright, I think that's enough. So as the robbers was beating Chippy up, not only did they beat her up, but they also took her clothes. They also took her things. They also took all of her money, and they left Chippy on the ground in painful agony. And the robbers grabbed everything and ran off. You guys get up for our robbers. All right. Pause the film. All right, take stunt double out, bring the real Chippy back in, who's now beat up with a black eye. There she is, she's on the ground now. All right, perfect. All right, take three and action. All right, so now Chippy is laying completely with only a few strips of clothing left. She doesn't have any money. She has a black eye. She's completely beat up. And she can't even walk. So she's trying to stand up, but she can't. And instead, she decides, "I'm going to lay down because I'm going to die here today. And then the Bible says that as Jesus is telling the story, one person walks by the road because she could literally die today. But one person walks by the road. You know who he was? He was a pastor.
Sorry about that.
I don't even know what this is.
It's my notification.
Oh, that is a loud notification. Sorry. Here, come turn it off.
I'm sorry about that.
I can't even open your iPad.
I feel so dumb. Sorry about that.
All right, turn it off and then go give it to Mr. Ryan for me really quick. I was like, where is that music coming from? No idea. All right.
Change it to an air raid.
So you guys pay attention to the story. So Chippy is no longer chipper. She is completely beat up. She is completely destitute. And she could die.
Okay, I think I got it.
So the first person that walks by is none other than our pastor friend. So Bryson, come on out here. You're going to walk right across the stage. And you have your Bible in your hand. You want someone else to play your part for you? All right. Let's grab Miss Josie right there. Joby, sorry. Right there in the pink, Bryson. There you go. She's going to be our pastor today. You guys give it up for our pastor. It's all right, Bryson. Great try, though. All right, so let's continue our story. And take three and action. All right, and our pastor was walking by reading the Bible, of course, because that's very, very important. And she was on the telephone. Believe it or not, she was on the phone. Act like you're on the phone. She was on the phone, the cell phone. Yeah, you're on the phone, girl. So she's on the phone, and she's talking to another pastor. And she stops in the middle of the stage, and she starts talking to him. And she looks over, and she notices that Chippy is sitting there, beat up, torn up, and without money, food, water. And she just looks at her, gets back on the phone with her pastor friend, and continues walking. Everyone goes, "Ooh!" I mean, how dare you? What? Do you think that that's very pastor-like?
No.
All right. And so Chippy starts crying a little bit. Who's going to help her? Who's going to help her? And so our worship leader comes by. And our worship leader's coming down the road. All right, you ready? Come on, it's your turn. She's playing the song, "How Great Is Our God." Sing with me. And then she stops. And she clears her throat a little bit. She notices that Chippy is sitting there on the ground, completely beat up, and asking for water. She's like, give me some water. And instead, our worship leader takes a drink of water herself because her throat was hurting her, so take a drink of water. It's so good. And decides to continue on her merry way. It doesn't even help Chippy. Is that nice? Absolutely not. So Chippy starts crying even more. You guys help me out with the crying. She's crying even more because she realizes... Alright, you guys can stop. Perfect. Y'all have great sound effects, by the way. But you gotta... This time, she decides she's gonna just lay down on the floor and she's gonna die today. She said, there's no one who's here to help me. When all of a sudden, a man starts coming, riding his donkey. Ah, yeah, you were wondering when that was gonna come in, okay? So they're coming in, and they stop right there, perfect, stop right there. Now, before they get too close to Chippy, Chippy realizes that she's a Jew, and he's a Samaritan. Now, in the Bible story, those two people did not like each other. Samaritans and Jews did not eat together, play together, read together, nothing, okay? So she tried to hide herself. And the only thing she could do was cover her face because she did not want the Samaritan to see her, because if he did, the Samaritan might even do more bad things to her. Because remember, the Samaritans and the Jews didn't like each other. So all she could do was cover her face, and she thought, this is it. He's going to kill me for sure. And so the Samaritan on his donkey walks right up to her. Perfect. He gets off of the donkey. He goes over to her. He kneels down to her and says, don't die. Today is not your day. And so he gives her some water to drink. He gives her a Big Mac to eat. I'm loving it. And then he grabs some Band-Aids and he puts a Band-Aid over her bruised eye. So as he's doing that, then he helps her onto his donkey. So help her onto your donkey because she needs a little bit of help. Huh? Can you pass? No, just help her get on your donkey. He's like, can I pass? I don't know if I want to help. Here, I'll come help you too. So here, you got to help her up a little bit. There you go, because she's beat up. And then she's going to be on the donkey. And instead of you getting on the donkey, you grab your stuff because you don't want to forget it. Oh, this is very important. Hold that, because that's next, okay? You're going to grab your donkey by the reins, and you're going to lead them to an inn. Perfect. And we're going to stop right there because there's your inn. All right, y'all going to turn around this way. Y'all going to come back in the middle of the stage. Come on back. The story is almost over with. Perfect. Donkey, you did a great job. One more donkey sound. Perfect. You guys get over our donkey. All right. Now, the Samaritan had the Jew. What was her name again? Chippy. And he came to the innkeeper and he gave him all of his money. You guys better pay attention. This is very important. And he said, take care of this Jew for me. Take care of her. She's beat up. She needs a doctor. She's thirsty. She needs water. She's hungry. She needs food. She needs new clothes. This should pay for everything. And I'm going to go off on a journey. I'm going to do what I was supposed to do. And I'm going to come back. And if I owe you more money, I will do so. And so the Good Samaritan headed off to do what he was going to do. And Chippy was able to have a nice recovery. You guys give it up for our volunteers today. They did a great job. You guys can bring all of your props, put them back in my prop box for me, and y'all can find your seats. Thank you so much, and cut. Good job, Jace. Thank you so much for standing up here. You guys give it up for Jace. Great job. Amazing. All right. Now, we had fun with that story, and we're almost done because we're going to play another game here in just a second. But before we play another game, I need y'all's attention. Remember, if you want your team to earn some points, you gotta be sitting up straight, not talking to your neighbor, not playing with your wigs, or your hats, or your costumes. You guys look great, by the way. Everyone say shh. So let's rewind and recap. Jesus is talking to all of these people. A rich young ruler comes up and says, Jesus, how can I live forever? And Jesus said, what does the Bible say? And he says, it says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, mind, soul, strength, and soul, and love your neighbor as yourself. And Jesus said, you're right, do that. And then he's like, well, who's my neighbor? Is it the guy on my right, or the guy on my left, or the guy in front of me, or the guy down the street? And Jesus then told the story, what I just told now, only we told it in a little bit more funny way. But it's true. There was this Jew who was walking on the street one day, got attacked by robbers, everything taken from him, and he was laying there and literally could have died that day. And so, the first guy that walked by was someone who was supposed to believe in Jesus, but didn't show the love of Jesus. They saw the person laying there and walked right by. Another person walked by, and again, should have showed the love of Jesus, but instead, kept on walking. Finally, the third person, who was a what? A Samaritan, saw the Jewish person, but instead of saying, oh, sorry, our people don't like each other, sorry you got beat up today, by the way, good luck with that, and walk on by. What did he do? He helped the person. He bandaged their wounds, he gave them water and food, put them on the donkey, took them to the inn, which is the hotel, and they got to get her doctor and all this other stuff, and that's a true story. And so at the end of the story, Jesus turned to the rich young ruler and said, which person, you guys answer this question, okay? But think about it. Which person showed the love of God? The first person, the second person, or the third person? Is that your final answer?
Yes.
That's exactly what he said. He said, the third person, Jesus, and Jesus said, you're right. Do that. Be that person. And he started thinking, really? I've got to love everybody, even people I don't like? Raise your hand if there's someone that you know, whether it's at your house or at your school, hopefully not your house, but somebody you just don't like. Everybody's got that person in their lives, okay? But here's our bottom line. You guys put your hands down. Miss Haley's going to throw it on the screen for us. Our bottom line for today is this, and it's really important for you guys to remember, okay? Because as we wrap up our behind-the-scenes series, this is the bottom line I want you to take away from. Love others because they matter to God. Can you guys say that with me? Love others because they matter to God. Now I want you to think about it. Do black lives matter to God?
Yes.
Absolutely. Do white lives matter to God?
Yes.
Absolutely. Do Mexican lives matter to God? Absolutely. Do people in Africa matter to God?
Yes.
Do people in China matter to God?
Yes.
Do people that you don't like matter to God?
Yes.
Do people who are bad people, like murderers and all these other bad people, do they matter to God?
Yes.
Yeah, because it says they matter to God. They meaning everyone. Someone say everyone.
Everyone.
Say it like you mean it. Someone say everyone. Everyone matters to God. Robin Hood matters to God, okay? Rocket matters to God. Pac-Man matters to God. Poison Ivy's matter to God. Princesses, kings, sailors, all of you amazing characters today, you matter to God. Why? Everyone look up here. We're almost done. We're almost done. You guys are doing great.
Okay.
Who matters to God?
Everyone.
Let me ask you again. Let me ask you again. We're going to dim the lights down, and we are going to play some prayer music. So I want to close in prayer. But here's the thing. Answer this again. Who matters to God?
Everyone.
You guys got to say it like you actually know the answer, okay? Who matters to God?
Everybody.
Everybody. You matter to God. Your mom, your dad, they matter to God. It doesn't matter what your mom has done. It doesn't matter what your dad has done. It doesn't matter what your brother or sister has done, your aunt, your uncle. It doesn't matter what your teacher has done. It doesn't matter if someone did something really bad to you. Even though they did that, they still matter to God. See, every single one of us have sinned. I've sinned and you've sinned. You've told a lie, I've told a lie. I've stolen something that wasn't mine. I'm sure you've stolen something that wasn't yours. Does that make you a bad person because you sinned? Everyone say yes. In the essence of sin. But does God loves everybody? Everybody matters to God. Can you imagine if you told a lie and God stopped loving you? Can you imagine that? Can you imagine if you stole something that wasn't yours and God stopped loving you? Can you imagine that? Now think about the people who do really, really bad things. People who murder. People who beat up other people, just like in today's story. What if they did what they did and God stopped loving them? would they ever feel like there's hope in the world?
No.
Even though people do small bad things and big bad things, God sees bad things as bad things. Doesn't matter how small or how big they are. And God loves everybody equally. So this is what I want you guys to do. Close your eyes, bow your heads, to cut off all distractions. Don't worry about your costume. You guys look great. Don't worry about the person next to you in their costume because they look great. Don't be messing with your hair or your costume. This is between you and God right now. I want you to close your eyes, bow your head, cut off all distractions from around you, and I want you to ask God this one question. God, what are you trying to teach me in today's Bible story? See, His Holy Spirit, His presence is with us right now, and He loves you guys. But even though we had fun telling our Bible story today as movie characters and costumes and props, Jesus told this story to that rich guy to teach him a lesson. And it's in the Bible to teach us a lesson. But what is that lesson? So ask the Holy Spirit right now, God, what are you trying to teach me in today's Bible story? And if you listen very carefully, I'm pretty sure it's going to be something along the lines of our bottom line that says love others because they matter to God. Now, I'm pretty sure there might be someone in your life right now that you have not truly shown them the love of God lately. Rather, it's a kid at school. Maybe it's your brother or your sister, your mom or dad. Now's your chance to make that right. So I want you to keep your eyes closed, your head bowed really quick. And in this moment, I want you to ask God, God, what do I need to do to make this right? How can I show your love to fill in the blank with that person? Rather, it's your mom, your dad, your brother, your sister, someone at school. There's someone recently that you have not shown God's love to. Who is it? And ask God, how can I show your love to them? God, we know that there's always someone in our lives that we can always show more of your love to. And Lord, as we conclude our sermon series behind the scenes and we're talking about love and treating others the way we want to be treated, today's Bible story meant even more to us, God, to where we can remember that it's not just the Christians that matter to you. It's not just the people who do good things that matter to you, but everyone matters to you. And so, Lord, I just pray over each and every kid and every single leader in this room that no matter where they go, no matter what they do, no matter who they see out their car window, no matter who they interact with at the grocery store, that they will remember that you love everybody and everybody matters to you. So, Lord, help us to show your love to every single person we come in contact with. In Jesus' name, and everybody says, amen. You guys say it like you mean it and say, amen.